This is Frank Cabrenia. He's a freelance writer and member of the Radish Guild. And this is Frank Miller. He's a PhD candidate in theater who graduates in June. One of these contestants, plus a lucky home family, will win a trip for two to Hollywood. Tonight on the final game of the Screen Test Tournament of Champions. And now here's the star of our show, the King of the Clowns himself. Here's Flippo!
Boy, we're ready for the big one, right? We're hot tonight. We even got camera people and everything in here tonight. We even hired a whole staff of engineers to run the show tonight. Keep it loose, Bruce. That's Keep It Loose, Bruce, on the camera. Everybody's here tonight. We're all hot because we're going to give away that trip to Hollywood. And nobody knows it, but I'm the consolation prize. I get to go with you. Okay, a special welcome to Cub Scout Pack 324 from Columbus, Brownie Troop 1057 from Columbus also. Hey. We also have the Ace Paper and Cardboard Company here. Got a carton of something on you? Anyway, and in the Indian Springs Church from Clintonville is here. Hi there. You folks from Indian Springs Church, is it true that you watch this show religiously? Where are you? Well, we're glad to have you here. Okay. This is it. This is the big night. Frank's all dressed up and everything. Where'd you see him? He never looked so good. This is the night we've all been waiting for. It's the final game of the Screen Test Tournament of Champions. Jerry Beck called in, wished his brother good luck. It's really terrific. See, his brother's an engineer. It's an inside joke. Shouldn't do inside joke. At the end of tonight's contest, we're going to find out who are the big winners of the Hollywood Happening. Yay! Okay. Now, in January, we began our tournament with 34 players divided into two brackets. Since then, we've had 32 matches, and after some stiff competition, we're down to our two finalists. They are Frank Cabrenia from the agency and Frank Miller. Hey! Okay. It's going to be a hot night tonight, folks. I can see it coming. Now, before we start our final match, let's talk with what's-his-name over there with the...
With the what? I've had a bad cold.
Frank, it's a shame you couldn't get any growth go up a little higher, yeah, there. But you're looking good tonight.
Excuse me. What?
You blew your nose, right?
I like that.
You know, you
Listen.
Smell better with that nose off. Well, anyway, did you think you'd
clump.
Get this far, Frank? In anything, for that
yes,
matter.
Yes, I did.
You
Flip.
Did? Is it on the other? Get the whole card.
No. Listen, Frank, yeah. My...
That's Frank Miller. Frank,
yes, yeah. I've heard
and
the
you're
name.
Frank Cabrenia.
He and I were contestants on the first time we came down for screenings on this show. We both came down at the same night. That was last summer. And it's amazing that we both got this far. And I've seen him play. I've seen his matches. I know how good he is. So, really, there's only one choice that I have because I'm convinced.
No, wait, I think that's a wrong move, Frank.
Wait a minute. It's not loaded.
We'll figure out something for you, Frank. You won't have
I got
to
water on my desk.
Okay. Well, we're glad to have you here, Frank.
You're welcome.
And also Frank Miller, our PhD in theater. How you doing? You
Pretty
nervous
good.
Tonight?
Huh? Yeah.
Are you nervous? Did you think you'd get this far?
I tried not to think about it.
You didn't think about it at all?
No. I just blanked it out of my mind. And
you're graduating in June. You're all excited
yeah,
about it.
There's
a lot
nervous.
Happening here
yes.
in this period
big
of time
life
for
here.
You. So, Frank Cabrenia and Frank Miller, congratulations to both of you. Give them a nice hand. As you know, Screen Test is a game show to test your knowledge of movie and TV trivia. At the end of tonight's contest, the studio winner and a high-scoring home family will win a cash prize, also a 50 bananas in cash money. You got that going, too. More important than that, tonight's studio champion and the family with the highest accumulated point total will win this grand prize.
It's a trip for two to Hollywood, California. Yes, our lucky winners will be flown to the star-studded city aboard a United Airlines Friendship Boeing 727 jet. And once there, they'll have 7 days and six nights to visit its famous landmarks and enjoy the sights. Plus, they'll take a VIP tour of Burbank Studios, home of Warner Brothers Motion Pictures. They'll be treated to lunch in the famous studio commissary where some of Warner's biggest movie and TV stars dine. But that's not all. Our studio and home winner will also be awarded a part in a Warner Brothers movie or TV show. This Hollywood happening worth over $1,000 is yours from Flippo's Screen Test. Back to you, Flippo.
Thanks, Mike. Now, here's how we play round one. Our studio players will have 1 minute in which to answer as many movie and TV questions as they can. Each correct answer you know is worth 10 points. Home players, now, based on what you've heard from our studio contestants, decide which player you think will win this round. If you're right, you'll receive the same number of points as the player that you choose. Choose your players carefully and touch butt number one for Frank Gabrena or butt number two for Frank Miller. Touch now. Go ahead. Choose them. You're hot tonight, Frank. Hot tonight. Home players, to be sure you're eligible for all rounds of play, leave your consoles tuned to channel T1 during the movie breaks between segments. That's when our computer determines who will be included in the next round of play. You guys ready? Okay, stand by, and here we go. We're starting the championship game. And remember, the home family that wins tonight and wins the $50 did not necessarily win the trip. It's the one with the accumulated points that wins the trip, okay? Here we are, gentlemen. Going now. In 1974's Murder on the Orient Express, who played the Swedish sprinter? Frank G.
Ingrid Bergman.
That's correct. Marlon Brando portrayed Napoleon in what 19... Frank Miller.
Desiree.
Desiree is correct. Who starred as John Monroe and Frank Gabrena?
William Wyndham.
That's correct. In the film With a Song in My Heart, what actress starred as singer Jane Frank
Miller? Susan Hayward.
That's correct. Whew, you guys are fast tonight. On TV's Gunsmoke, what's with Chester's last name? Frank Miller.
Fisk.
Not correct. Frank Gabrena.
Good.
Good is good. This year, Peter Sellers was nominated for Best Actor for his role in what film, Frank Gabrena?
Being There.
That's it. Who played the lady judge in 1947's The Bachelor and the Bobby Soxer? Frank Miller.
Bernal Loy.
That's it. Marty Ingalls and John Astin starred in the title roles, Frank Gabrena.
I'm Dick and C's Fenster.
That's correct. Who took Ward Bond's place as wagon master? Frank Miller.
John McIntyre.
That's correct. In Kitty Ford... Go with that. Don't eliminate... Finish the question. In Kitty Foyle, she won an Oscar for Frank Gabrena.
Ginger Rogers.
That's correct. She... Boy. You guys are something. That's the end of round one. Frank Miller, you're low with 40 points. In the lead by 20 points is Frank Gabrena with 60 points. To our home players, that means if you touched in for Frank Gabrena, you got 60 points. If you touch button number two for Frank Miller, you got 40 points. Okay? Now, that's what you're going to start the round with. We'll be right back with more of the final game of the Screen Test Tournament Champions right after this break.
A movie with everything. The combined talents of 10 Academy Award winners. The best musical score since Mary Poppins. And Elliot, the incredible super magical dragon. The biggest, most dazzling fantasy in the history of the Disney studios. Walt Disney Productions, Pete's Dragon, rated G.
Glad I shaved that mustache off. Well, welcome back to Screen Test. We're ready to go again. Recapping the scores, Frank Gabrena has 60, Frank Miller has 40, and we have 55 homes all tied up with 60 points, okay? Now, home players, here's how we play this round. I'll ask a question. We'll show you three possible answers. You'll touch button number one, two, or three. Each correct answer is worth 20 points. However, as you know, as a special bonus, if both studio players are stumped by the question, we double the point value for all home players who touch them with the correct answer. You'll get 40 points for it. The contestants in the studio don't see the choices. They write their answers on cards that we've provided. Remember to touch when you see the signal and hear the music. Here comes the first question. This actress was born in Springfield, Ohio in 1896. She starred in such films as Way Down East and Broken Blossoms. Name her. Three choices at home. This actress was born in Springfield, Ohio in 1896. She starred in such films as Way Down East and Broken Blossoms. Name her. Everybody ready? Frank Abrenya, who was that?
Lillian Gish.
You got it. Frank Miller.
Lillian Gish.
You got it. All right. 20 points for everybody. We'll touch button number two at home. Okay, listen to this song.
Stars are gonna twinkle and shine this evening about a quarter to nine. My loving heart
are gonna tend to... You know what's sick? You know what makes me ill? I know that song. That's about a quarter to nine. Sung by Al Jolson at about a quarter after six. What 1935 film is that song from? You're listening to About a Quarter to Nine, sung by Al Jolson. What 1935 film is that song from?
My loving arms wanna tenderly twine.
Frank is still writing there. It's okay, Frank. We still got some music to play for you. You too, Frank?
It's not shorter questions next time.
No, it's a shorter answer that we need, Frank.
Oh,
questions, okay.
Star-Spangled Rhythm.
Star-Spangled Rhythm. Gee, all that writing and you bummered out, Frank. Frank Miller.
Go Into Your Dance.
Boy, you got that right. How did you pull that out? Go Into Your Dance. Button number three for the folks at home. 20 pointers. All right, here we go. This TV show was a rock and roll type series during the mid-1960s on ABC. It featured many top names in popular music such as Sonny and Cher and Glenn Campbell. The show's host was Jimmy O'Neill. Name it. Pull that one out, boy. TV show, a rock and roll type series during the mid-60s on ABC. It featured many top names in popular music such as Sonny and Cher and Glenn Campbell. The show's host was Jimmy O'Neill. Name it. Everybody ready? Frank Abrenya, name it.
Shindig.
Jeez, how'd you do that, Frank? Frank Miller.
Shindig.
Gee, both of you. Shindig is right. Button number one at home for 20 points. Okay, take a look at this picture on the monitor. Here you go. That's a scene from the 1942 classic movie Casablanca. It stars Humphrey Bogart and Ingrid Bergman. At the Academy Awards in 1943, how many Oscars did this film win? Okay. You're looking at a picture from Casablanca, 1942 classic movie, starring Humphrey Bogart and Ingrid Bergman. At the Academy Awards in 1943, how many Oscars did that film win? Everybody ready? Frank, how many?
Three.
Three is correct. Frank Miller.
Three.
Three is right. Button number two at home for answer number three. Next question. Dick Tracy, Chester Gould's famous comic strip detective, appeared briefly on television from 1950 to 51. In this series, who starred in the title role? Dick Tracy, Chester Gould's famous comic strip detective, appeared briefly on television from 1950 to 51. In this series, who starred in the title role? Everybody ready? Frank Abrenya. Who was that?
Chester Morris.
No, it wasn't Frank. Frank Miller.
Ralph Byrd.
How do you do that? That's right. Comes up with a wild butt number three for the folks at home for 20 points for you and Frank Miller. Okay, the round is over. Let's take a look here. All right, Frank Abrenya now trailing with 120 points. Frank Miller in the lead with 140 points. We still have one more round of the game. Anyone can still win tonight's $50 prize. Don't forget our computer is adding points to your total every time you touch the right button. We'll return to give you a chance to score even more points toward that Hollywood happening right after this.
Remember American Graffiti? Well, now there's more. More American Graffiti, from protests to rock and roll, from drag strips.
Well, I don't know too much about cars. I'm from New York.
To body shops, from bad brakes.
How does latrine duty sound to you?
To headaches. It's what's happening in the all-new More American Graffiti, rated PG.
All right, now comes our final round where anyone can still win tonight's big game. Recapping the scores, Frank Abrenya with 120, Frank Miller with 140. Of all shows, I had to get two guys named Frank, the final one. It's a very Frank show tonight. Once again, I'll be asking movie and TV questions, but this time with five possible answers. You at home will determine the point value of each question. Let's say that 60% of our home viewers are correct, leaves 40% incorrect. The value of the question would be 40 points. At the end of the round, we'll find out who'll win $50 in cash and the Hollywood happening. Incidentally, we have one family in the lead at home now with 160 points. Okay. Gentlemen, you set? Here come to face question. He was a Charlton Heston of his time in the 1926 version of Ben-Hur. He is well known for his role as Rupert in 1922's The Prisoner of Zenda. Who is he? Okay, he was a Charlton Heston of his time in the 1926 version of Ben-Hur. He is well known for his role as Rupert in 1922's The Prisoner of Zenda. Who is that person? Everybody ready? Frank Abreu, who is that?
Raymond Navarro.
You got it. Frank Miller.
Raymond Navarro.
Right on. But number five for the folks at home. Let's see what that question is worth. The percentage of home viewers who answered correctly was 18%. Lots of points, gentlemen. That means the question is worth 82 big ones to both you guys. And everybody at home with touch button number five, of course. All right, here we go. She was born in 1910 in Palisades, New Jersey. It was producer and husband-to-be Walter Wanger or Wanger. How do you pronounce that? You guys know?
Wanger.
Walter Wanger, who changed her to a brunette in the film Trade Winds to cash in on the Eddie Lamar look. Name her. Okay? She was born in 1910 in Palisades, New Jersey. It was producer and husband-to-be Walter Wanger, who changed her to a brunette in the film Trade Winds to cash in on the Hedy Lamarr look. Name her. We ready? Okay, Frank, who's that lady?
Deborah Padgett.
Not correct. Frank Miller.
Joan Bennett.
Joan Bennett is correct, but number four at home. All right, let's see what the question is worth. The percentage of home viewers who answered correctly was 41%. That means the question is worth 59 big points to Frank Miller. And everybody at home to touch button number four. Next question. In 1977, this TV show won the Emmy for Outstanding Comedy Series for the 1976-1977 season. Name it. Okay, five choices at home. In 1977, this TV show won the Emmy for Outstanding Comedy Series for the 1976-77 season. Name that show. Everybody ready? Frank Miller still writing. Okay. All right, Frank O'Brien, name that show.
MASH.
Not correct. Frank Miller.
All in the Family?
Not correct. It was the Mary Tyler Moore Show, or butt number three at home. Okay, let's see what the question is worth. The percentage of home viewers who answer correctly was 28%. Means the question is worth 72 points to our home players on button number three. The final episode of The Fugitive was telecast on August 29, 1967. It was seen by more people than any single episode of a regular series in the history of television up to that time. In this episode, Dr. Kimball finally caught up with the one-armed man. Who starred as the one-armed man? Final episode of The Fugitive, telecast August 29, 67. It was seen by more people than any single episode of a regular series in the history of television up to that time. In this episode, Dr. Kimball finally caught up with the one-armed man. Who starred as the one-armed man? All right. You ready, Frank?
Yep.
Okay, Frank Abreu, who was it?
Anwar Sadat.
No, it wasn't, but he could have played that role. He could do about anything. Frank Miller, who was it?
William Smith.
William Smith. No, it wasn't. It was Bill Raisch, or butt number two for the folks at home. Let's see how much that question is worth. The percentage of film, boy, it's going to be a biggie. The percentage of home viewers who answered correctly was 27. There you go. All right. That means the question is worth 73 points. All right. Keep in mind that our home players get choices to make. You know, it's multiple guests for them. These guys got to bring it out of the mind here. All right. This actress enjoyed regal status at MGM because she was married to the studio's production chief, Irving Thalberg. She won an Oscar for Best Actress for her performance in The Divorcee. Name her. Okay, five choices at home. This actress enjoyed regal status at MGM because she was married to the studio's production chief, Irving Thalberg. She won an Oscar for Best Actress for her performance in The Divorcee. Name her. Frank, you know who that lady is?
Norma Shearer.
That's correct. Frank Miller.
Norma Shearer.
That's correct. Button number one at home. For the correct answer, let's see what the question is worth. The percentage of home viewer answered correctly was 37%. Means the question is worth 63 points to both of our players here. Here we go. In 1877, the British photographer took a series of pictures of a horse in motion, okay? He later displayed his pictures rapidly in sequence, which led to the beginning of motion pictures. Can you name that man? In 1877, this British photographer took a series of pictures of a horse in motion. He later displayed his pictures rapidly in sequence, which led to the beginning of motion pictures. Name that man. Okay, Frank, are you ready?
Who was that guy? Edward Muybridge.
Edward Muybridge is correct, Frank Abrenia. That's right, Frank Miller.
Yeah, free screen? No.
It wasn't. It was Edward Muybridge. That's correct. Button number two for the folks at home. Let's see what that question is worth. okay, the people answered correctly. It was 37%. That means the question is worth 63 big points. All right. All right, everybody. The round is over. And now we're going to declare our winner. Frank, you tried hard there. Could bring it with 328, but Frank Miller, 344 points. But Frank O'Brien, you've been a lot of fun to work with. You've been a tremendous contestant. Mike Young, tell us what we have as a consolation prize for Frank O'Brien.
You bet, Flippo. It's this Kodak Colorburst 50 instant camera with a motorized print ejection. It's easy to hold and requires no focusing. For the times of your life, trust Kodak. This camera, film, and flash bulbs are yours, Frank Cabrera, from Flippo's Screen Test.
All right. Thank you very much. Now, in a moment, we're going to be back to find out who is tonight's high-scoring home family and the winner of $50 in cash. Plus, we'll announce which home family has accumulated the most points during the entire tournament and is the big winner of the Halloween happening right after this. We'll be back.
City, 1959. The battleground was rock and roll, and a disc jockey named Alan Freed lit the fuse that ignited a nation.
Boy, you just can't stand to watch a bunch of kids have a good time, can you?
I can't stand what you're doing to these kids. You're making them behave like a bunch of animals.
Look, you can close the show. You can stop me. But you're never going to stop rock and roll. Don't you know that?
It was the beginning of an era. You should have been there. American Hot Wax. Coming from Paramount Pictures. Rock and roll is here to stay. American Hot Wax. Between love and death is the bloodline. Sidney Sheldon's Bloodline, the number one bestseller of love, intrigue, and murder among the international set. Audrey Hepburn, Ben Gazzara, James Mason, Claudia Mori, Irini Pappas, Michelle Phillips, Maurice Rone, Romy Schneider, Omar Sharif, Beatrice Strait, and Gert Froba as Inspector Max Hornung. Sidney Sheldon's Bloodline.
Did a good job, Frank.
Thank you.
And this trip's going to be a nice little graduation present, right?
That's not bad.
Get your PhD and a trip to Hollywood all in one big wonderful package. All right, now before we announce our Tournament of Champions home winner, let's take one last look at our grand prize.
Right, Flippo, it's that trip for two to Hollywood, California. Yes, our lucky winners will be flown to the star-studded city aboard a United Airlines Friendship Boeing 727 jet. During their 7 days and six nights, they'll take a VIP tour of Warner Brothers Burbank Studios, where some of today's biggest movie stars often work. But that's not all. Our studio and home winner will also be awarded a part in a Warner Brothers movie or TV show. This Hollywood happening worth over $1,000 is yours from Flippo's Screen Test. Back to you, Flippo.
All right, we are getting ready to announce our home family, and we're still computing the scores, right? I tell you what, Frank, we have a gentleman here from United Airlines, and he's going to tell you all about what you're going to do over there in Hollywood. Hal Parker, come on in from United Airlines. Hey, welcome, hello, Hal. Hello.
Congratulations, Frank. Thank you. Congratulations.
Welcome to the Tournament of Champions here, yeah, and I understand you got a terrific deal going for these folks.
We sure do.
And I want to talk to you a little bit later about what kind of a thing we can work up, because they might need someone to carry the luggage.
Well, we can get you on there.
Yeah. See, there's usually a seat or two up in first class, isn't there?
Way up in the cockpit. You could
Why
fly.
Not? Okay. That's good. I love that. All right. Tell us what's going on, Hal, with United. Go ahead.
Okay, what we have here, in conjunction with United Airlines' new service to the West Coast, our nonstop service to Denver and to L.A., we're going to present the winners, the home winner and the studio winner here, with round-trip passes for two to L.A., and they will also have a budget rent-a-car out there for the week.
Hey, terrific.
And they will have a hotel at the Marriott Inn for 7 days, and they'll also have passes to Disneyland while they're there.
Well, it sounds like you got everything all together there.
They should enjoy
it. It should be a terrific trip. Everybody's very busy accumulating scores. Have we got it? Huh? They're going to stay at Stovall's Best Western. Is that
Stovall's Best Western?
Out there in L.A. Okay, we want to make sure we get everybody their proper credits, because when they get out there, it's going to be a super trip for everybody. So we want to thank you for coming by now. I think we're about ready to go. Are we all set? All right, we're going to name the high-scoring home family for tonight's game. Not yet. Would you like to dance, Hal?
Oh, sure.
We're going to name the high-scoring home family for tonight's game, and our computer has tallied the scores of all our home players, and our winning family has how many points? Tell me quick. We don't know how many points? Then how do we know that, huh? You want me to announce that? All right, go ahead, Mike. Tell us who the home winner is.
Well, we don't know the exact points, Flippo, but our winning home family tonight is the Z-Handler family of Cortland Avenue, right here in Columbus.
Hey, Mike, you'll be interested to know that they had 459 points. Okay, now where are we? Our computer has... they win the $50, right? Our computer has added in the points earned in tonight's game with the total points accumulated throughout the tournament. Our winning family has 10,507 points. Okay, Mike, tell us who that is, please.
It's no surprise, Flippo. Our Hollywood Happening grand prize winner is the R.L. Oglesby family of Dunedin Drive, right here in Columbus.
The Oglesbys did it, eh? Congratulations to the Oglesbys and the Handlers. We have to get going. Bye-bye, everybody, and we'll see you Thursday with a special edition of Flippo's Screen Test. We're winding it up next Thursday. Hal, okay, thanks a million. Frank, congratulations to you.
Some members of the Screen Test studio audience tonight will receive a certificate for a large pizza, Domino's. Domino's has 24 locations in Columbus to give you fast, free delivery. Or tickets to see the Columbus Clippers in action at Franklin County Stadium. Or a certificate toward a meal at any Mother's Pizza Parlor and Spaghetti House. Mother's feed you best with their quick services. Come on home to any one of Mother's three Columbus locations. Stay tuned for a special one-hour edition of Columbus Alive. Dick Wolfsey will be talking about and with gifted children. That's Columbus Alive next on Channel T1. This is Mike Young speaking for the final edition of Flippo's Screen Test, a QUBE presentation.